I've already postponed this video for more than 2 years because of the pandemic and many other things. I decided to do it now while I still remember how to do it, because this project is actually already done a long time ago. This time I will show you how to install the Outrunner brushless motor, or the motor that usually used on drones. We will install it on the WPL 2-speed gearbox. It can be used in almost all types of MN or WPL RC, such as C24, C35, B16, MN, D90, etc. The advantage of Outrunner motor is it has a very large torque. But if you want to upgrade to brushless motor for speeding, you can use an inrunner brushless motor. The upgrade process is easier, and we already have the video for it. Link is on description. The advantages of this conversion. First, it's pretty cheap. Second, brushless systems are generally more battery efficient. Third, we don't need to change brush like when we use brush system. And four, it has a lot of torque, very suitable for smooth crawling. This is an example. This car uses WPL C34KM wheel set with a weight inside the tire, but it can climb smooth and easy, although I only touched the throttle a little. It has much more torque compared with standard 370 brush motor. In this video, I mostly use 2208-1100kV motor, but I also two other motors so that you can decide it which speed is suitable for you. I buy this motor for less than $5. To use this motor, we need to make an adapter like this using 3D printer. The purpose is so we can install the outrunner like a normal 370 motor on the gearbox. These two small holes is for screw to the gearbox, while two larger holes are for holding the outrunner motor. I'll give you the 3D files for free. You can download it on Thingiverse. Link is on description. If you want to sell the printed material for your profit, feel free to do so. Just don't sell the design or the soft file. Now what we need to do is remove the 80 pinion gear from the 370 motor that came with 2-speed gearbox. You can heat the gear then use pliers. Or you can use RC gear puller like this. Don't buy the aluminum gear puller as it is too large for this 80 gear. Use the one that looks like in this video. Just rotate the handle to remove the pinion. Or instead removing the original pinion, it is better if you buy the 80 pinion gear with 5mm outer diameter. It's for a backup if the pinion is damaged, and we don't need to remove the stock pinion in case we want to refer it to the original. Now the problem is the 370 motor shaft size is less than 2mm, while the outrunner motor is more than 3mm shaft size. So the 80 pinion gear won't fit the outrunner shaft. Hence, we need to reduce the shaft size first. I highly recommend you to buy an outrunner with 3.17mm shaft size. The reason is because we can find the spare part. The length is about 40mm. If you own the spare shaft, you don't need to worry if there is a mistake on the process or if it's broken. You can simply buy the spare shaft. The price for one shaft is around $1. Now we remove the pin on the back of the motor using small flat screwdriver. This is the inside of the outrunner motor. Open the grub screw using 1.5 hex key. We need to remove the shaft because we will flip it. You can use 3-inch or larger C-clamp. You can also use a bench vise. Use a socket wrench or a hollow steel rod so we can push out the shaft. Use an M3 bolt at the other end to push the shaft. Now we already removed the shaft. Before reassembling, we make a flat section for the grab screw. Make it on the part with locking strip. Don't make it on the other end because that's where we're going to install the pinion. Don't make it flat to the end. The limit is the line strip. I use 8-inch flat file. It won't take too long. You can also use grinder or mini grinder, but do it carefully. Several ways to reduce the shaft size to make it fit the 80 pinion. You can use a drill and flat file. This is the fastest method. It can be done in less than 5 minutes. However, there is side effect. The drill head is usually not that precise. You can see from the light reflection, the end of the shaft is wobbly. We can still use it, but it will make the gear sound a bit rough. The second method didn't need a drill. First, we installed the shaft to the motor, match the flat part with the grub screw hole. Then we push the shaft using vise or C-clamp. We install the grub screw. We install the motor bracket. We usually get this when we buy the motor. Then we connect the motor to the brushless ESC. I'll explain more at the end of the video about electronic installation. Then we connect the ESC cable to the servo tester. This device costs around $2. Plug it in the outside. White wire to S or signal, red to positive, black to negative. It is not mandatory to buy servo tester. I'll explain it briefly. Then we put the motor to the vise. If you don't have the bench vise, you can screw it to the wood board or something. The point is to hold the motor. Cover it with plastic to avoid iron debris. Turn on the AC, and this is the function of servo tester. We can turn the knob to run the motor. If you don't have this device, then just use the transmitter to run the motor. Then just use a rough sandpaper or flat file. If you use this method, it takes more time than using drill, because we cannot press or use more force to finish it quickly. But the result will be better and precise. To make it faster, and if you own it, you can sand it using mini die grinder. And I use this method. If you own vernier caliper, always check the shaft size. If you don't have it, just match it with the gear. Depending on the 80 gear that will be used, if it is new, make the shaft approximately 1.9 mm in size. But if you use loose gear, make a 2 mm shaft. I once made a 1.8 mm shaft and it turned out too small, and in result, the pinion is loose. To fix this, we can use iron glue or red Loctite to tighten it if the gap is still tolerable. This is the end result. You can see the end shaft looks smaller. Now we install the adapter. Depending on your 3D printer tolerance, if the screw hole is too small, then we need to make a thread using small screw. Just the top of it is enough just to make it easier installation later. No need to screw it through. But if you own good 3D printer, no need to do this. Make sure to install the adapter first before install the pinion gear, because you won't be able to install adapter with pinion gear on. Install the pinion using a vise or C-clamp. If it is too hard to enter, don't force it. The gear will break. Reduce the shaft size again. Then we install the motor to the gearbox. Just screw it as usual. Make sure the pinion gear is aligned well with the gear inside the gearbox. You can feel the pinion position must be at a level or slightly above the gear shaft holder to the right of the motor. I already designed my adapter in such way, so if you use a 2208 motor with 4 cm long shaft, it should be perfectly aligned without need to do some adjustment. But make sure you check it first in case you still need some adjustment. And we have finished assembling the gearbox. For ESC, I use Hobbywing 16BL30. 16 means it's suitable for 1/16 scale RC, BL stands for brushless, 30 means 30 ampere. For this motor, you don't need to use large amperage ESC. Approximately, you can get same if not bigger power like when you use 60A ESC with brush motor. So if we use this system, you can get good power and longer playtime as it more energy efficient. You can use some cheap $12 RC car brushless ESC, and the performance will be quite same. I use Hobbywing just because it already waterproofed. We plug the motor cable to the ESC, yellow wire to yellow wire, while the remaining two cables can be installed inverted, more of this later. The 2208 motor usually use 3.5 mm bullet connector. If you use larger ESC and you feel the connection is loose, maybe your ESC use 4mm connector. Hence, you need to buy and change the motor connector to 4mm size by soldering it. Plug the cable from ESC to the receiver. We got this receiver when we buy a third-party transmitter. In this video, I use Dombo RC X6 transmitter. Of course, you can use other brands, but you cannot use the stock WPL or MN transmitter as you won't get the receiver like this. Plug the ESC cable to receiver channel 2. White cable is for signal, red is positive, and black is negative. Plug the steering servo cable to channel 1, yellow cable for signal, red positive, brown negative. Finally, plug the servo cable for changing gears to channel 3 or other empty channels depending on the transmitter you use. Plug the battery, turn on transmitter, then turn on ESC. If you pull the throttle and the car goes backward, change the normal to reverse switch on the transmitter to invert the motor rotation. The other way to invert rotation, you can also change the motor cable position. For example, we return to switch to normal position first. After that, we switch the two cable position on the motor. We leave the yellow or middle cable as before, but we swap the left and right cable position, left to right and right to the left. This will change the motor rotation. It's safe to do this in sensorless brushless motor. You need to swap the cables if you feel the forward rotation slower than reverse. If the process is correct, the gear sound will be relatively quiet like this. This dual-speed gearbox still uses plastic gears. If you use metal gears, it will be noisier. I'm really satisfied with this outrunner motor performance. It has a lot of torque and it also smooth for slow crawling. This is the speed of 1100 kV motor in high speed gear mode. It's still sufficient in my opinion. Even in high speed gear mode, I can still do smooth crawling. So, I rarely use the low speed mode. The conclusion is, I think 1100 kV speed is too slow. Meanwhile, this is speed when using 2600 kV motor. If you like speeding, you might love this. For your info, I install a quite lot of weight on the front of the car, but you can see the car still able to do a wheelie. However, 2600 kV is too fast for smooth crawling. We can still use it off-road, but we need to pull the throttle deeper in heavy conditions. Hence, it will make the motor and ESC work harder. So, in my opinion, ideally, we use a 1400 kV motor for smooth crawling, and if you want some speed, 2200 kV is a maximum. Buy a 2208 size motor. Don't buy the 2212, because it uses same shaft. And if we install it backward, the shaft won't be long enough to reach the gearbox gear. Unless you can get a shaft that is longer than 4 cm. If you still want to use the 2212 motor, you can do it without using a 3D print adapter to make the motor closer to the gearbox. But we need to make a quite lot of modifications to the gearbox, and I think it's not worth to do, but it's your call. Again, if you can find an outrunner motor with shaft longer than 4 cm, you can install it while still using the adapter. For example, this purple motor is 2216 size and has longer shaft. The size even bigger than 2212 motor. Also, it uses a strong magnet, way stronger than the cheap gold motor we previously saw. By the way, the sound of the motor is really loud. It's not a gear mass sound. Does it perform better? The answer is no. We need to pull the throttle deeper to start this motor, probably because it is a larger motor and use stronger magnets. So we need extra power to start the motor. That's why I suggest you use a 2208 motor, because it's cheap and it performs more than enough. Just to remind you, I add pretty much weights on my car and it's still able to crawl smooth and easy. The one that broke are my gears, my hex, slip tire, and so on. Can we use outrunner motor below the water? Yes, we can. Just clean and dry it after play in water. Rust is your enemy. In fact, I think it is easier to clean the outrunner than to clean inrunner motor. We just need to blow dry the outrunner. After all, if somehow we damage the outrunner, the price is relatively cheap. We don't need to repeat the shaft sanding process again. Just remove the old shaft, then move it to the new motor. It's easy. What is the drawback? The drawback is if you play in the mud, because the rotating part is on the outside, the mud will make the motor rotation heavier. That's why if I play on the mud, I position the gearbox higher, so the mud won't reach the motor. I use some razors that I already mentioned on the previous video. Clean it with water if the motor feels heavy after playing on the mud. Just note, if it's in clear water, it won't affect the motor rotation too much. That's it, I'm Teddy, and I hope this video can be useful for someone.